Hi guys, today I am going to discuss and explain about the difference and similarity between the programmable logic controller and distributed control system, which are used widely in industries for automating the process and making the system more efficient and flexible. And in our earlier videos, we have discussed enough about PLC, that is programmable logic controllers, and in our previous video, we have discussed the architecture and application and things like that about DCS as well. So in this video, we are going to differentiate both of them in terms of its capabilities, advantages, disadvantages, and so on. Let us start with, first let us understand the architecture of a PLC. The PLC is an industrial computer or a industrial microcomputer, which is designed for a rugged operation and harsh environment. It has to sustain or survive in a harsh environment, which has its own processor, and it will have its own interfaces, input and output interfaces, and we need to have a programming device to program these PLCs. So the programming can be of any language like ladder logic or a function block diagram or structure or a list or any other programming methods. And then we have the memory to store the program as well as for executing the datas, and we have communication so that it can communicate to the field devices like a VFD and other processor or other controllers as well. Yeah, so the input interface is useful to connect the input field devices like sensors. So the sensors can be of analog sensor or digital sensors. So the analog sensors will be connected through A to D converter. So that is analog to digital conversion will take place before the data get into the processor. And if it is a digital, and the digital signals also may be the voltage level and the current levels may be not readable directly from the processor. So it needs to be converted into the readable format and the readable voltage and current levels before it going to the processor. So once these data are getting into the processor, the program will be executed as per the program which we have written either in a ladder logic or statement list, and then the processor executes the program and it produces the result, and these results will be given to the output interface where the digital signals which is coming from the processor will be converted into the digital signal which is readable from the device or field devices like a relays or contactors or whatever solenoids and things like that, or it can be converted into analog signal if it is analog devices like motor controls and things like that. So this is the total operation or total process which is taking place in the programmable logic controller. So we'll have the input scan and then program scan and then the output scan. So this is how the total scan takes place. So this is very fast and then very accurate as well, and it can control or it can connect hundreds of input output devices, mostly of a discrete in nature. So this is about the PLC. And when it comes to the DCS, the DCS has many components involved in it. So we have field devices, same like our PLC, field devices, and the number of field devices may be very large enough. Large number of field devices will be connected to DCS because of its nature and the size of the plant which needs to be controlled. Based on that, the number of sensors could be more, and the number of analog signals or the analog sensors will be of different, and it will be of very high numbers as well. So we are going to have the input output modules or the interfaces here, and then we are going to have the controllers. The controllers, maybe we will have a two controllers in each unit or each place, so for achieving the redundancy. And then we are going to have the HMI here to monitor the process at the area level or the particular machine level. And then these datas which are required from this controller will be fed to the server, and from the server it goes to the archiving computer, and also it goes to the operator station. So these PLC's programming will be done from this designing station. The designing station is the one, or the engineering station is the one where we are going to write the codes and write the programs for the PLC as well as the write the programs for the you know, at the graphical level, whatever we need to monitor, like liquid level, tank level monitoring, liquid level flow temperature, like that graphical way, whatever we want to monitor, everything will be designed from this designing station, and which will be fed to the required areas, like controllers and servers and things like that. Yeah, so this is how the DCS system looks like. The operator station is the place where the operator monitors the overall process which is happening throughout the plant. And since I told you here, we have different areas or different zones for achieving different tasks. So all these systems are connected to different controllers, and all these different controllers are connected to a common bus. It may be of a Profibus or Ethernet bus, so it connects all the devices, and the communication takes place between the controllers as well as from a control to server and archiving computers and designing station and so on, and from there it goes to the operator station as well. So the communication network plays a very important role here, since the devices and the controllers are placed far away as well, and more number of controllers are get connected. So we need to have a high speed communication network, like HART network or Profibus network or Ethernet network, something like that. Yeah, so this is the basic architecture of a DCS. So you can easily understand the difference between the PLC and DCS from these two pictures as well. So now let us get into the details. So if you see a PLC, the PLC is mostly designed or used for controlling a machine which has maybe few hundreds or few tens of input and output devices, so which will have its own control logic which is written in the PLC, and the process controls will be of very less numbers because of its own limitations, and then the controller controls the program devices according to the program which is written. And in case if you want to monitor the status of the process, so we can have the HMI system here or any other monitoring system here. Okay, so this is you know, the machine level or a particular area level, small kind of operations. So it can be from few sensors to few hundred sensors can be connected to PLC, and the PLCs are very fast enough to do the work, and it is also very accurate in nature, and it is very robust as well. But when it comes to DCS, the number of field devices is going to be very high, because it is going to control and monitor very big process, like refining mills or power plants or something like that. Very big operation it is going to control. So even in industries as well, it is going to control various levels of the operation. So it is going to have more number of input and output devices which will be connected to the area wise controllers, and these area wise controllers are spread across the plant, and these controllers is going to control that particular operation in one particular area, and it is going to communicate to the other controllers as well as to the you know, monitoring station and the designing station, something like that. So in architecture wise itself, we have a huge difference between PLC and DCS, but nowadays we have the features of DCS in the PLC itself. The PLCs are having sophisticated you know, controls, like function block diagram programs, and more number of inputs and output controls, and we have more control loops in the PLCs, so it will have its own benefits as well. So nowadays the difference between the PLC and DCS is very narrow, and you know, it can be interchangeably used, and based upon the application and requirement, we can choose whether we want a PLC or a DCS. So if you see in the PLC system, which is going to have similar features like a DCS, when we have instead of the dedicated controllers here in DCS, we can have multiple PLCs which can you know, interchange the data between the PLCs, and then it also can give data to the monitoring systems. But only difference is along with the PLC, there is no inbuilt monitoring system or monitoring system softwares available. like a SCADA or any other monitoring system needs to be installed separately, and it has to be communicated with the PLC. But in the DCS, it is an overall package which is coming together as a controlling and monitoring in a single package. But it is interchangeably achievable. So what DCS is doing, it's now almost we can achieve it in the PLC itself. So here, if you see a process, when the DCS controls the process and the PLC controls the process, if you see the PLC, the standalone PLC is going to control the total process, like we have a conveyor and then we have a machine which is going to squeeze the metal into a conductor or a piece of metal, and then we are going to have a cooling mechanism here. So these three different stages are controlled here with three different controllers. So when one particular stage, if the this particular controller is failed, so the redundant controller will take care of the operation. In case both fail, then that means only that particular process will be get affected, the remaining process will keep going. But here in the PLC, if the PLC is you know, stopped working, then that means the total process will be obstructed and it will stop working. So this is a difference here. So this is what I mean. So if this particular processor is or controller is not working, so that means this process is not taking place, but the remaining two process is taking place here. But in case of PLC, if the PLC is not working, that means or if it is not in the operating state, that means the total process will be in off state or it will obstruct. So where shall I use this PLC and DCS? If you have a more number of discrete application, then we can go for a PLC, mostly in automobile industries and any manufacturing industries which will have more number of discrete inputs, like digital sensors, level sensors or position sensors, like that we will have a more number of discrete sensors. So based on these discrete sensors, the number of sensors are very high. And the analog sensors, where we have only few number of analog sensors, be temperature control or pressure control or flow control, only few control loops, then we can go for a PLC. And in case if it is a continuous process where we have more number of analog controls or more number of analog signals are coming, we have to monitor more number of analog parameters, and then we need to have more number of control loops, then we need to go for a DCS, and which is going to be complicated in nature. And in some places where we can have PLC and DCS, we can use interchangeably, or we can merge them together. So where batch process, more you know, medium number of discrete and medium number of analogs are used, so there we can interchangeably use, or we can merge together this PLC and DCS. And response times as concerned, the PLC is faster than DCS because of its scalable nature. So PLCs are limited to less number of inputs and less number of outputs, and the program what we write also is not very big program, and based on the input and output scan and then program scan, timing will be less. So based on that, the PLC is faster than DCS. The DCS will have complicated loops and complicated process which is taking place inside the program, as well as the inputs, the more number of inputs and more number of outputs needs to be executed each cycle. So DCS will be a little slower than PLCs. So programming language is concerned, so we are going to have a low level language. Most of the PLC designers are using ladder logic or FBL, that is function block diagrams, or a statement list. But in the DCS, mostly we use a high level programming, facilitate the programmings, and the programming will be a bit harder and difficult than PLCs. So if you see the monitoring system along with the PLC, we will not have the monitoring system inbuilt with it. We have to design and we have to connect a specialized monitoring system, like we will have either SCADA or we will have our HMIs. So it's a different system we have to integrate with the PLC so that it can work together. But in DCS, it is a inbuilt software which will have its own programming software as well as the monitoring software which can be connected to the DCS and which will be easier for connecting and programming as well. So this point already we have discussed. In DCS we will have more amount of analog signals and less amount of discrete signals. In PLC we will have less number of analog signals and more number of discrete signals. So in a nutshell, similarities and differences. PLCs are compact and modular control system that typically uses a CPU unit and input-output modules. DCS is a larger and more complex control system that uses multiple controllers distributed throughout the process. This is what I said. So if you want to control a machine which has maybe 50 or 60 inputs and 20 or 30 outputs, so PLCs are connect the PLC and do that work. But when you have a process which has more number of inputs and more number of outputs and the types of inputs are like analog, digital, and we have different inputs, then it is better to go for a DCS. Used for control of a smaller and less complex industrial process such as manufacturing lines and machine controls. Used for control of large and more complex industrial process such as power plant, oil and gas production, and other processes as well, like some of the pharmaceutical applications and things like that, we are going to use this DCS. As a limited number of input output points and can be handle a limited number of control loops. This is important. This control loops, that is it is going to have few number of analog input and output devices, can handle a large number of input output points and control loops. Since the processor are designed for that, so it can handle more number of input output points, and then more amount of analog type of sensors can be used and analog outputs can be controlled. Typically uses a ladder logic or function block diagram programming languages for programming. Here we are going to use a sequential function chart and a function block or structure test. So these are the different programming methods used in DCS. And typically uses a simple and robust industrial communication protocols. Here we are going to have Modbus, Profibus and things like that, HART communication and like that. We are going to have different communication requirements. As per the requirement, we are going to use the communication networks. As a limited data storage and data handling capabilities, so since we are having a small memory capacity in PLC, it cannot store more amount of data, so it is also not having archiving computers and things like that. So DCS has data storage and data handling capabilities and often used for discrete control application. Here it is used for continuous control applications. PLCs are faster, no doubt about it. Response times of 1/10 of a second makes the PLC an ideal controller for near real-time actions such as safety shutdowns and firing controls. Yeah, DCS takes much longer to process data, so it's not right solution when response times are critical. In fact, safety systems require a separate controller. So here in PLC the redundancy issues are there, but in DCS there is no much redundancy issues are present. So actually when you see the PLC and DCS both born or both brought into the industries at almost the same time in 1970s. So PLC comes earlier, which is meant for replacing the relay logic circuits, which we know that in earlier industrial manufacturing plants where we are going to have the controls and logics done by relays. So which will be very complicated for designing as well as troubleshooting and things like that. So PLCs came as a replacement for that relay logics, and DCS came into action to replace the PID controllers, so which will deal about the analog inputs and outputs. So this is the major difference between the PLC and the DCS. Nowadays the PLCs are having more sophisticated tools and things like that, so it can do a lot of work similar to DCS. And the future trend of this PLC and DCS will be integrated with IIoT, that in the industrial internet of things, and which will make both PLC and DCS will be sophisticated data transfer and things like that, and which will have more advanced controls and data communication you know connectivity between one plant to another plant, or those things will be achieved in a greater fashion or a good way for PLC as well as DCS. So that will be the future of our PLC and DCS and the industrial automation. Hope you understand the difference and similarities between PLC and DCS. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment box. Thank you. Thank you so much.